to pieces when I look at you, 'cause you're my thrill.
The world lost a brilliant actor, Sidney Poitier, on January 6, 2022. Old Black Hollywood would like to pay tribute to the greatest actor who lived.
I'll remember mine.
Sure, Chief, you do that. Or maybe you'd like to take a walk down to the principal's office right now with me. Is that what you want?
You holding all the cards, Chief. You want to take me to see Mr. Warnicky? You do just that.
Who's your home period teacher?
You are, Chief.
Why aren't you with the rest of the class?
I already told you. Came in to wash up, Chief.
All right, then wash up. Just cut out that chief routine, you understand?
Sure, Chief. That's what I've been doing all the time. Okay for us to drift now, Chief?
I want to catch you in here again.
Suppose I got business here, Chief.
Look, how many times do I have to tell you? Let's go, huh? Come on, let's go.
Let's go, bright boy.
Hey, wait, he means me.
Well, it's English lesson time. I build a chapel.
I build a chapel.
You build a chapel.
You build a chapel.
Oh, we build a chapel.
We build a chapel.
He built the chapel.
Amen.
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 I got a boy who's got to sleep in the living room because I got nothing, eh?
Nothing to give him but stories. Like on how rich white people live, eh?
Eat your eggs, Wally.
Damn these eggs. Damn all the eggs that ever was.
And go to work.
I'm trying to talk to you about me. Now all you're going to say to me is eat these eggs?
You never said anything new. I listen to you every day, every morning, every night. You never say nothing new. So you'd rather be Mr. Arnold than be a chauffeur. So I'd rather be living in Buckingham Palace.
And that's just what's wrong with a colored woman in this world today. You don't understand about building your men up, making them feel like they're somebody, like they can do something.
Our colored men do things.
No thanks to the colored woman.
Being a colored woman, I guess I can't.
That's exactly where it's at.
Yeah, and what I mean to say is...
No, you said what you had to say. You listen to me. You say you don't want to tell me how to live my life. So what do you think you've been doing? You tell me what rights I've got or haven't got and what I owe to you for what you've done for me? Let me tell you something. I owe you nothing. If you carried that bag a million miles, you did what you were supposed to do. Because you brought me into this world. And from that day, you owed me everything you could ever do for me, like I will owe my son if I ever have another. But you don't own me. You can't tell me when or where I'm out of line, or try to get me to live my life according to your rules. You don't even know what I am, Dad. You don't know who I am. You don't know how I feel, what I think. And if I try to explain it the rest of your life, you will never understand. You are 30 years older than I am. You and your whole lousy generation believes the way it was for you is the way it's got to be.
And not until your whole generation has lain down and died will the dead weight of you be off our backs.
You're tired?
Mm-mm. But don't you need to sleep?
No, I like to walk. And I like the way you walk. And Paris is a city to walk in.
It's a beautiful city.
Yeah, it takes more than 2 weeks to see it, though. Can't you stretch your time a little?
No, I have to go back to school.
You go to school?
Mm-mm. I'll start teaching next term. What's that?
Notre Dame.
You didn't even look.
Well, I didn't think they'd moved it.
I guess you pointed it out to lots of girls from here.
One or two.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe three.
Well, it's lovely.
So are you. And I've never said that to any of them before. Well, not more than one of them. Not more than one on this bridge. You know, if I had a teacher like you when I went to school, boy, yeah, I would have learned some.
I think you've learned enough.
Not in school.
You said something about buying me some onion soup.
It won't run away.
No, but I might.
You might. Run from here. The garden spot of the Western world, you might run. And not just what you see, but the way the place makes you feel. I'll never forget the first day I walked on Avenue Champs-Élysées. Just like that, I knew I was here to stay.
How long have you been away from home?
5 years.
You've never wanted to go back?
No. You stick around Paris for a while and stretch a bit. Sit down for lunch somewhere without getting clubbed for it, and you'll wake up one day, look across the ocean, and you'll say, who needs it? Who needs it?
Well, we certainly don't need to sit down for lunch and get clubbed for it.
Amen.
But we do need our roots, don't we? And where our roots are, our home is. Wouldn't you say?
I would say that you're one of them socially conscious chicks, right?
Home to me is home. My family is my family. And whatever problems they've got, I've got them too.
Of all the beautiful girls who come to Paris every year, I get a swinger for the cause. Well, I can't fight you on an empty stomach. Besides, we've just met, so I think I better take you.
The nominees for the best performance by an actor are Albert Finney in Tom Jones, Richard Harris in This Sporting Life, Rex Harrison in Cleopatra, Paul Newman in Her, Sidney Poitier in Lilies of the Field. The winner is Sidney Poitier in Lilies.
Because it is a long journey to this moment, I am naturally indebted to countless numbers of people, principally among whom are Ralph Nelson, James Poe, William Barrett, Martin Baum, and of course, the members of the Academy. For all of them, all I can say is a very special thank you.